Hi friends, thank you for joining in. And today we have Saugata Paul. I have my notes so that I don't miss anything important. He is one of our students, a very hardworking student, somebody who moved from a services company as a senior systems engineer with close to 3 years experience to a data scientist at a very interesting company which works on computer vision and NLP in Chennai. And he also had a little break. So let's learn about his journey of going from a senior systems engineer to a data scientist. Let's walk through the whole journey. Welcome, Saugata. Thank you very much for taking the time and helping us and also all of our students learn about your journey, because journeys like this could be very inspirational and motivating for lots of students. Thank you.
Thank you. I have done a couple of other courses as well, like maybe full, maybe some part of it. But I haven't come across anything as applied AI, anything close to applied AI in the entire subset of courses that are there in this universe. Like, it's not like I have done a lot of courses, but few of them, I would rate applied AI at the number one position given any courses.
So let's learn about your journey also. So can you walk us from the time you were a senior systems engineer at Infosys to the time at SPI Global? We'll also learn a little bit about the work that you're doing at SPI Global a little later.
Right. So I did a BTech in computer science.
Okay. You did a BTech in computer science. Okay.
So after that, I passed out in 2015 and then I joined Infosys in the same year. And what happens in Infosys when you get through a company like Cisco, at the beginning, it will be a training for 4 or 5 months. Then you get promoted to systems engineer role and senior systems engineer role. So in that 2 years, I was mostly working in web development and web development related support.
Okay.
So I kind of interested in machine learning for a very long time, like interested in bits and pieces, but I did not have the theoretical understanding or even practical knowledge on how to approach certain problems and all those things. So I was thinking for a job change, but I was not ready to move into another web dev role because I felt stagnated at that point of time. And my passion was never web development, to be honest. Like right from my college days, I was really passionate about cyber security, ethical hacking and all those stuff. But as it happens, like if you don't nurture your passion, it goes away at some point of time. At one point of time, I just wanted to study about learning. So prior applied AI, I was in Infosys. Mm-hmm. I did some courses from Udemy. I found those courses to be very good. But at the same time, I also realized that this is not sufficient enough for me to break into the machine learning industry. Because these courses mostly focused on an overall aspect, like a bigger picture of what happens. But I wanted to actually dive deep into how machine learning algorithms works, how this things works internally, and how we can solve multiple problems. I started applied AI. I saw this course, and I within like 3-4 days, I enrolled to this course, and I started. Initially, it was extremely interesting. Don't get me wrong. Like,
sure,
what
sure,
happened?
Please be critical. I mean, critical feedback always helps us improve.
Initially, I was very excited with all of those excitement starting this new course and all. So I started this course, and after like 1-2 months, I realized that I am lagging in pace, and especially after quitting my job when I needed a job change. So
you wanted to get into a job quickly.
Yeah, I wanted to get into a job quickly. But then I realized that rather than focusing on getting in a job quickly, it might take some certain time, but I'll do this course at the end of the day. And I want to finish this course and let's see where it goes. So I had, by the time I already had put enough faith on you guys, like, because in my head, I was clear, like if I do this course well enough, given the materials that are there and given the way you teach, getting a job won't be that much difficult after we complete this course.
That's also our confidence. We are extremely confident about the content assignments that somebody who completes it should easily be able to get a data science machine learning role fairly easily, because I mean, that's because this comes from our experience of doing hundreds of interviews.
That's what. And this job guarantee program also motivated me a lot to take up this course. As I told you, like initial 2-3 months, it was very exciting. Then I lost a little bit of pace. Then I decided that I need to quickly pull my up. the assignments were some of the assignments initially, although they were very easy to me now as I look back, but initially when I started doing it, those little concepts also I needed enough time to explore and
it is,
do
well. So you learn during the process of assignments, which will help you actually in your job. So that's
exactly
the whole point of it. You said you pulled up your sleeves and said, I'm going to work now. And as you rightly said, your performance also improved. How did you stay consistent and regular in your learning experience? Because that's one of the most important things that we ask our students to do. Please be persistent. Please be regular. Once it becomes a habit, it's very easy to complete the course.
Exactly. Exactly. That's what I felt at that time also. Because initially, even though it was exciting and all, I was a little laid back, to be honest. Like, I did not put in enough number of hours. So, like, what happens generally when you start a course, you see the number of hours it has, 200 hours or 250 hours, and you calculate how much time you can put each day. So I had done all the calculations in my head, and I was totally a failure in sticking to it for the first 2-3 months.
That's okay. Then as I realized, long as you pace back, that's okay.
So then I realized if I continue in this pace, I won't be able to finish the course. There won't be a job, and there will be a lot of difficulties for me in the future. So this kind of I was scared, first of all, and this also motivated me to learn quickly and do as much videos as possible, and more than the videos, be consistent and solve the assignments. But with time, slowly after completing each of the assignments and getting feedback from you guys, critical feedbacks, what am I lacking, what should I improve, what is good about this particular thing. So this kind of helped me improve in the long run. And the assignment feedbacks and valuables and the mentorship offered by people in Applied AI were extremely good, extremely good.
Finished your learning process of completing the assignments, being persistent with it. Could you help us? I think you did 3 interviews, right, in total via Applied AI course, job guarantee program?
Yes, yes.
Okay. So how did the course contents and assignments that you have done, how did they help you in the 3 interviews that you have done?
All right. So first of all, without the course assignments, the interview wouldn't have been cleared for me, because the questions I was asked in the interview in all 3 of them were mostly related to core knowledge in machine learning domain, which was very helpful for me since I had done the course already. Like there were a lot of questions which I wouldn't have been able to answer if I wouldn't have done this course specifically. The case studies that were there, they helped me a lot in approaching different problems. Like in machine learning, what happens? You have a vast array of problems. There are not a single domain that you can stick to. So it's very important to know, even if you don't have necessary knowledge to solve a problem, you should at least have an idea how to approach it. The rest of the things will automatically follow. Like you can do search on that. You can look at others, people, what work they have done in the related fields and all those stuff. But having that knowledge on how to approach a certain data set or a certain given problem is a tradecraft thing, like, yes, which I wouldn't have been able to learn.
That without, was the whole point of having so many case studies and having self case studies, because that's the whole purpose.
And every case study in Applied AI was more or less different. Only there was one case study when I did was Amazon Fine Food Reviews, which had like 10 or 12 assignments related to it.
That's because we use it as a running example through the course to introduce you to concepts.
No. And that was very helpful to me, because had that experiments been on different data set, for example, if you would have done logistic regression on Amazon Fine Food Reviews, and if you would have done naive Bayes or decision trees on any other data set, it would have been difficult to understand the correlation between these machine learning algorithms on a single data.
Yes, that was also the purpose, that on the same data set, what happens if you apply a wide spectrum of algorithms? That was also the key objective. Exactly. There.
And generally what happens in industry also, I have seen after now I'm working as a data scientist in my company. So I have seen like in industry also, these things happen a lot. Like you are never sure like what approach will work for a given data.
We can't guess it. We can make a guesstimate, but we can never perfectly guess it.
Exactly, exactly. So that's what happens. So you experiment more with different techniques, and one fine day some technique will work, some won't. But when a technique doesn't work, it's not the end of the world there. Like, we can always change our approach and sort of things like that.
So we'll go back to some of the work you're doing and get some few insights on that also. How did the job guarantee program itself help you at the end of completing all the assignments and things like that? Can you just walk us through that process?
Yeah, definitely. So the job guarantee was valid for candidates who would complete 30 assignments and all. Otherwise, there was no job guarantee. There would be job assistant if I don't complete 30 assignments, but there won't be job guarantee.
Yes.
So given the stressful situation I was in back then,
You completed all the assignments. I've seen through your assignments. Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. So I did those. After that, I started getting calls. And I was lucky that I could crack the first interview that I got through.
Which is K Global, right?
Yeah, but after that...
It's a very interesting company. So
yeah, definitely.
Just to give a context to some of our viewers, SPA Global is a company that we've been working almost close to 2 years. And they've set up their whole computer vision NLP teams. They build products and very interesting stuff around computer vision and NLP. And they also have some corporate training program with us. And they have hired multiple good candidates from our programs. And it's a very interesting company based out of Chennai. Yes, please.
Yeah, so after going to SPI Global, like prior to me and after me, there were like more than total 6 or 7 recruitments from Applied AI.
Yes.
And now we are just like a family and friend in office.
Cool.
So, it's good to meet with people who got as much as me from the course. So that's what even they tell me, keep on telling me, like, probably without Applied AI, they wouldn't have been able to transition into this role. And there were some guys from Bosch and other notable companies where they were working as software engineers or system engineers, but they wanted to shift into DS roles. And what I found common with all these people who were hired for my company from Applied AI course, that they... Like for them, they always believed that the transition was not going to be easy. Like it won't be a 2-3 months thing.
Yes.
All of them
are not 2-3 months. It is not a 2-3 months thing.
Yeah. So it's not a 2-3 months thing. All of them were clear about it. So accordingly, people just had that vision in mind that I need to complete this course. I need to finish the assignments. And this will help me a lot, not even in terms of finding a job, but also in terms of understanding and approaching different problems with machine learning skill set. Like since I have learned this course or graduated from this course, a lot has changed in machine learning in the last 1 year.
Things keep evolving as we go.
Yeah.
It's a very dynamic field. So after you got selected with SPA Global, I think you also interviewed at a couple of companies, but you finally decided to join SPA Global, right?
Yeah.
So total of 3 interviews via the Applied AI course job guarantee program. And you got
actually,
to
actually there were 4 interviews.
4 interviews.
Yeah. So I gave for 3. The last one I didn't attend because I didn't want to work in Calcutta.
Okay. You skipped the last one because you decided to anyway join in Global. SPA Global is a very old company, right? It's been there from the 1980, if I'm not wrong.
Yeah.
But I had one specific question. Let's not go into the numbers, but I wanted you to give us an estimate of your compensation. Please don't give us numbers, but roughly what is the increase in your compensation from Infosys to SPA Global?
Compensation wise, it was significantly more than double the salary I used to get in Infosys.
Oh, okay. So you got more than double of what you are getting at Infi.
Yeah, more than double. More than double. I would say it's 2.3 times, I guess.
Okay.
Of what I
That's a
used
good
to get
significant payback. Both, even financially, for the effort and the risk that you have taken, of course, certainly intellectually it is better because you always wanted to work in a cutting edge field.
Exactly.
Broadly speaking, right? What are your recommendations for students who are currently pursuing the Applied AI course? What would your 3 most important recommendations for them to be successful? Because there are a lot of students like you who are transitioning from 2 to 3 years of software engineering or systems engineering experience, sometimes even more. And who are moving into who want to move into careers in data science and machine learning? What are your top 3 hints or top 3 suggestions for them?
Top 3 would be, I would say, you will have to have that self belief yourself that you want to do this for the rest of your life, and you need to believe that you can do it. Second thing is, you have to be very consistent with the course schedule, because the course schedule might initially look very easy at first. But trust me, it won't be easy if you don't know how to manage time. But like as I have said, initially I was also not very sure about how to go. But then I had certain plans. I used to write down how many hours of video content I will study, I will watch today, and I used to stick to it every day. And because for me, for some of the assignments, I was never sure how much long time will it take. It might take a day, it might take two, or it might take 3 days. But watching videos is under my control, right? If I fix that I'll watch 2 hours videos, I will watch 2 hours videos. So that is, you have to be consistent in that. And definitely solve all the assignments. Because this is not only for getting job. This is not only for getting job. Job people will get. But solving all the assignments will give you enough confidence and knowledge on how to approach multiple problems. Because I think the problem diversity that is covered in applied AI is huge. Like in most of the industries, like more than what I feel is more than computer vision right now, there has been a lot of huge work over the last couple of years and maybe more than that in natural language processing.
Oh, yes. So, NLP has taken off in the last couple of years like crazy. I mean,
crazy. Exactly. Computer vision, I would say, still isn't like there are many practical applications
but
of it.
Still, but we use ResNets, which is slightly old, while GPT-3s, GPT-2s, BERTs are still quite recent relatively.
Exactly. So that's what the field is evolving to a such a huge extent. So the course content really helped me a lot. That's what, just complete the assignments and complete the self case studies. One important thing that you always insisted was learn to learn. Like, I would be honest with you, before coming to Applied AI, I was not very comfortable in reading like complex articles or blogs or even research papers. But when I was in Applied AI, during that entire 1 year when I did this course, this might not be my best skill, but at least I am in a better position right now than before on how to read a research paper and how to approach it. Because most of the things that you are there in the research paper. So you just have to understand it and implement on your own.
Yes.
So this is one good thing that Applied AI has given me. And
we've also added new assignments which ask students to implement more of the algorithms step by step, so that when they go to the industry, it's much easier for them to implement a slightly more complex model.
Exactly. So, and also I would this is just my advice, like Applied AI gives notebooks, right? So I would urge students, if possible, run those same codes in Jupyter or some IDE where you can put debug pointers and debug and see what is the flow like. Because what happens, you see a significant patch of code, you understand somewhat, but unless you debug it line by line, it won't be easy for you to understand.
Oh, so you're suggesting let's take that code, debug it in a standard debugger so that you understand it much better. That's a good suggestion. That's a good suggestion.
Like, even I did the same thing, because there are some things which I faced problems. And it was maybe a very minor issue which I didn't understand at that time. Maybe 3-4 lines of code also I couldn't understand because of some reason or some unable to understand the flow. So when I put those same things and assembled in Spider and debugged it line by line, I used to come up with insights on how this is working and what can I do more with this. These kind of approaches.
One more interesting thing is we still have roles that SPI Global wants to fill. They've reached out to us recently asking us to recommend more candidates. We are hoping that you'll have more colleagues from Applied AI course.
Definitely.
We have some good students also now. Hopefully, you'll have more colleagues from Applied AI course.
I look forward to it.
Cool, Shagata. Thank you very much. On behalf of our whole team, all of the mentors, our placements team, and most importantly, our students who would have surely benefited from this discussion of ours and have taken some points, certainly a lot of motivation and inspiration from your journey.
Thank you, Varma sir. It's been a pleasure to be a part of this wonderful journey with Applied AI. Because as I've always stated, without Applied AI, I probably wouldn't have been able to transition into DS roles and all. Because at one point of time, I had no idea where to start from, what to start with. So once I started taking Applied AI, everything followed a certain pattern. Like, it was always step by step and slow incremental learning. Like, it was never a pushing sort of thing where you learn one thing and push for something else in the very next day.
Okay, Shagata, thank you very much. Thank you for taking the time during all of this personal and professional hectic schedule that you have. Thanks a lot.
Thank you so much, Varma. It means a lot to me.